Morning. Good morning, Grace College. Good morning. My name is Wally Brath. I'm the professor of worship arts here at Grace. Thank you. Thank you. I know this is kind of a tough time of year because, you know, it's the end of the semester, the end of the year, and I think everyone's feeling a little spent. And hopefully today will be refreshing for you. This is our third New Song Chapel. Is that right, Brent? Maybe our third one. And it's a time when students get to share some original music. You're going to hear some songs, you know, coming out of maybe the pandemic and just different things that people have been processing. But even if you're not a musician, if you're not someone who writes music or does art, you can still hopefully this will be something that would encourage you. Just whatever sphere of influence, wherever God has put you, wherever He's called you in school and in your vocation, to just use your imagination and to be curious. I think one of the things in my life that has been such a blessing and it really has helped me to connect with the Lord is to be curious, just to be curious about life and about the way God interacts with us in His creation, and also just to exercise your imagination. So you can do that obviously at school, but in any way. I mean, even if I was just mowing the lawn the other day and decided I would just kind of mow it a different way and see what the design would look like. Just little things, just exercising your imagination, being creative, and it really adds joy in your life. This is I want to read a quote from C.S. Lewis. He said, art and music are not the thing itself. They are only the scent of a flower we have not found, the echo of a tune we have not heard, news from a country we have never visited. So I think even when we listen to good music or read a good book or see some visual art or even just go out into to nature, we're getting this echo, it's almost a deposit that God has given us that it's pointing to something else, that there's going to be a new creation, a new heaven, a new earth, and this is not the end of the story. So today I just hope this is an encouragement to you. I also wanted to just plug, if you want to put that picture up there, the Worship Arts Program, we just completed our first CD, our first worship project, and you can find it on Spotify. I think it's on all the different streaming services, but if you wanted, I think if you search for Grace College Worship Arts, you'll find it on Spotify. Definitely share it if you like it. Also, the name there, Reclaim Proclaim, is referring to finding some real gems of lyrics and scriptures from the past, and sort of reclaiming them, and then doing some original melodies and arrangements, and really being able to proclaim those in a fresh way. That art piece of artwork is by Dia Jenkins, just a wonderful artist. You can follow her on Instagram as well. But yeah, so let me pray for us, and we're going to hear from some really talented students today. So let me pray. God, thank you so much for this opportunity to be here together. Lord, you've been so faithful to us this whole year, and we have felt just you sustaining us in many different ways. And God, we just need your help as we're finishing up this school year and projects and papers and finals and things that have to happen. God, many of us are traveling right after graduation on different trips, and we pray for your help there as well. We pray for our seniors who are really seeking you for the next chapter in their journey. And so we lift them up to you. God, I want to lift up Ukraine as well today and pray for your help there, that you'd stop the war. And God, give gospel peace to Ukraine and to the people there. And Lord, we are so thankful to be able to enjoy your creation, and especially today just thinking about music and the awesome language that music is and the way it ministers to us so deeply as it engages our heads and our hearts. And today we just want to offer this New Song Chapel to you, and pray that it would just be a sweet offering to you. Be with these students as they share their music and share their hearts. And God, we just want to enjoy today and enjoy you in that process. Pray in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, we invite Gwyneth up.
All right.
Hi, like you said, my name is Gwen Boyke. And this song we'll be singing for you guys today is taken from Hebrews 6 as part of a Hebrews collection that I've been working on for the past 2 years. Last year I sang from Hebrews 3. And in writing these pieces, I went directly chapter by chapter and tried to write songs for each one. And I did my best to take strictly from the holy words of Scripture rather than my own, so that to be reverent to God's eloquence rather than my own lowliness and depravity. And I guess in that lowliness and in that depravity, it may seem like hopeless, but I know, according to this chapter, that I can have faith that God's promise will be fulfilled, even though I don't deserve it. And in Hebrews 6 talks about how we can be certain in God's sustenance for us while we are still sinning and disappointing him. So I use a lot of the chapter in this song, but there's a specific passage that I want to read to you that really stuck out to me. It starts from verse 17. It says, "So when God desired to show more convincingly to the heirs of the promise the unchangeable character of his purpose, he guaranteed it with an oath, so that by two unchangeable things, himself and the oath, in which it is impossible for God to lie, we who have fled for refuge might have strong encouragement to hold fast to the hope set before us. We have this as a sure and steadfast anchor of the soul, a hope that enters into the inner place behind the curtain where Jesus has gone as a forerunner on our behalf, having become a high priest forever."
Oh,
Rocks are crying out, hallelujah to the one I praise, hallelujah, holy King of Kings. I'll give a hallelujah to my only hope. You are the sure and steadfast anchor of my soul. Now there's no more waiting to obtain the promise that you'll enter in the inner place behind the curtain. Lie with you now. Found by your grace, alive with you now. Consider us found by your grace. Thank
Good morning. My name is Jonathan. Some of you may know me as the one that rollerblades around campus. I just have a little song to share with you all that I wrote a few years ago. Some of you may know I, like some of you, were homeschooled, raised in a Christian home. And, you know, in that environment, looking back, it's very easy to take it for granted that everyone is a fellow believer in Christ, raised in that environment. You learn to say all the right things, but sometimes you don't see what's going on deeper inside. And I remember, especially shortly after graduating from high school, seeing a handful of my friends run away from the gospel that they were raised, surrounded by, and going as far as they possibly can in the opposite direction, and that just breaking my heart. And not seeing it coming at all, like never suspecting it. And, you know, oftentimes we're told that there's an urgency for us to preach the gospel because if we don't, there's some people that may be suffering eternally in hell. And I do think that should be compelling, maybe not our primary motivation. I think we should primarily be motivated by our love for God to share that with others. But it hits particularly close to home when the concern is for someone that is a close friend that you really love. And that's what this song was birthed out of, having one particular friend shortly after I graduated high school in 2018, that his family went through a traumatic experience, and I could tell it was causing him to wrestle with his faith, causing him to doubt, and I think that in that time he probably, even though he was still saying all the right things, I think he probably didn't want much to do with God, and by extension, me, and so though we were once close friends, we just kind of drifted apart, and that broke my heart. And I remember just spending a lot of time in prayer and anguish, even weeping over it. And the thought just weighing really heavily on my mind one day that I might get to heaven, and he might not be there. And that was really hard for me to think about. And I remember just at one point thinking that, and I just, out of my emotions, sang this song. And I thought, maybe I'll write that down. And that's what I'm going to be singing for you today. So I didn't think I was going to do anything with it, but here we are. And honestly, even though it's my heart for our unsaved loved ones and friends, it also extends to all of you as well. I hope, you know, I know that if I'm saved, if any of us are saved, it's only going to be by the grace of God through Jesus Christ alone. So I hope that every one of us will continue in that grace in which we stand and endure to the end. For every one of you, when I get to heaven, by his grace, Lord willing, I don't want to get to heaven without you. So.
Without you,
forgot to transpose the key. Take two.
I'm going to adjust this because I am not as tall as Jonathan is, so give me just a moment. Okay. Good morning, everyone. My name is Hallie, and I'm a fourth year here at Grace. Shout out to my fourth years out there. So 2 years ago, I was an RA in Westie, Westie 3 East. So yeah, it was amazing. I loved my experience and loved my girls on my hall and had a really good experience there until COVID had shut it down and sent all of us home, which I'm sure all of you are familiar with that to some extent. But I just remember the end of it just really being kind of sad because, you know, you're pouring into these girls all year. And if you're an RA right now, I'm sure you understand that and you're starting to grieve that a little bit, just the end of your hall and your hall community. But for that to end so abruptly was just so wild. And I was trying to grapple with these feelings. And at the same time, my RD, Bree Heim, some of you might remember her. She was awesome. She had challenged our RA cluster to write a lament. So just looking at different biblical laments from David or even the Book of Lamentations and just the structure of how someone would go from crying out to God just in agony and then kind of making this progression of turning their eyes towards God and to his promises and to his character. So she challenged us to do that. She challenged us to write our own lament. And I was like, well, I'm stuck in quarantine. What better to do than to put some music to it? So I did that. And it was just a really cool space for me to be able to hold the truth of who God it is, but also to hold the truth of my pain and my suffering and the things that I had to say goodbye to in that time. So I pray for you this morning that if this is a space right now that you need to lament something, if you need to grieve something, if there's something that is still on your heart, weighing on your mind, even as the school year comes to an end, that this would just be a space for you to grieve it. So this is called More Like You. Heavenly Father, it's me again, your daughter. I don't mean to waste your time. Creator, sustainer of life, do you have time to deal with mine? You didn't tell me everything would end this way. There was no warning. Did I somehow make a big mistake? Or is this all a part of the process? No warning.
doing this on my own. I know it's a process to become more like you. Fighting a battle I can't win on my own. Calm this storm in my mind. Come and save me from myself. Thank you for telling me everything would be okay. Thank you for promising it won't always have to be.
Thank you.
Okay, this is a song that Sam and I actually wrote for one of our classes last year. I think it was History of Christian Worship. It's a WALI class. And so we didn't actually write the words of it. It's a hymn that was written in 1833 by Adoniram Judson, who was a missionary. It's about the Holy Spirit. That's pretty much it. we wrote the chorus. I think something that was impactful for us in the writing process was just that line of "Come, Holy Spirit, come." And so that's now the chorus. As we sing it, we're inviting the Holy Spirit into this place.
It's not on the page, but this is Liz. She's cool. She wrote all the string. This is on the EP that Wally was talking about, and she wrote all of the string arrangements for it. It's pretty awesome.
Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, dove divine. On these baptismal waters shine, and teach our hearts in highest strength.
to praise the Lamb for sinners slain. We love thy name, we love thy laws, and joyfully embrace thy cause. We love thy cross, the shame, the pain. God for sinners slain. Come, Holy Spirit,
come, breath of life, the fire of
love. Come, Holy Spirit,
come, breath of life, the fire of love.
Come, Holy Spirit,
come, breath of life, the fire of love.
We sink beneath thy mystic flood. Bathe us in thy cleansing blood. We die to sin and seek a grave. With thee beneath the yielding wave. Come, Holy Spirit. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Xander, and I'm going to do a song I wrote about a year ago. I'm going to do a song I wrote about a year ago. It's called Someone, and it's just a song I wrote for pretty much all my friends, because I've had a lot of my friends go through some pretty rough times. I'm like, hey, how you doing? They're like, I'm great. No, you're not. So I just want them to know that I'm here for them. I just kind of wrote it for them and let them know that the Lord's here for them. Is this all good? All right. Sweet. Hope you enjoy.
Hold babs in your eyes, but you always say you're fine. You won't put your guard down, but you're breaking down inside. You can't kill the heartache, no matter how hard you try. But don't you know I'm always here to say, breathe just a little, take some time, you'll be alright. See just a little, you and I, we will survive. Tell me if you need someone to brighten up the day. I know I could be someone who sees. Tell me if you need someone to be on when it's tough. 'Cause I know I could be someone to hold you up. Wish that I could find a way to say how much I want you to cast all your cares aside. You brought them a long way, and I wanna see you thrive. We both know you wanna let go of the fears that break. Stride, but don't you know I'm always here to say, breathe just a little, take some time, you'll be alright. See just a little, you and I, we will survive. Tell me if you need someone to be on when it's tough. 'Cause I know I can be someone's one to hold you up. Tell me if you need someone to brighten up your day. 'Cause I know I can be someone's one who sees there. Tell me if you need someone to open up your eyes to all the things around you that are blessings in disguise. Tell me if you need someone to be there when you cry. Be someone. Tell me if you need someone to be on when it's tough. 'Cause I know I can be someone's one to hold you up. Tell me if you need someone to brighten up the day. 'Cause I know I can be someone's one who sees.
Well, as my bandmates come up, I just wanted to share a little bit about the song we're about to play. We played this song the other night at our show. Was anyone there? Yeah? Thanks for coming. There will be more to come, so keep your eyes and ears open for that. Also, we released like a CD. We had a bunch of CDs. We're soon going to release them to the world. Via other, like, the internet. But we're too cool for that as of right now, so. This song we're going to play is on there. It's called Hardly Sleep. I started to write this song the night that I had my wisdom teeth taken out. I was in a lot of pain, and I couldn't go to sleep. You know that feeling? Like, you can't fall asleep. And it's not because you're not tired. You're just in writhing pain. Anyway. I was mad at the world, I was mad at God, I was like, okay, whatever.
So I wrote the song, and then it kind of evolved into just becoming a song that's, we've had a lot of kind of lament and angsty songs today. This is another one. It's about loss and just, you know, dealing with change and losing things and people and just figuring out how to do better. So you'll kind of hear the theme of, like, there's like these sad sections of the song, and then we like burst into these moments of joy, and it's like, yes. So feel free to stand. Let's stand, right? We're a rock band.
He made you stand, and now I'm going to read this angsty psalm to you, all right? I cry aloud to God, and he will hear me. I sought the Lord in my day of trouble. My hands were continually lifted up. All night long, I refused to be comforted. I think of God. I groan. I meditate. My spirit becomes weak. You have kept me from closing my eyes. I am troubled and cannot speak. I consider days of old, years long past. At night, I remember my music. I meditate in my heart and my spirit ponders. Will the Lord reject forever and never again show favor? Has his faithful love ceased forever? Is his promise at an end for all generations? Has God forgotten to be gracious? Has he in his anger withheld his compassion? So I say, I am grieved that the right hand of the Most High has changed. I will remember the Lord's works. Yes, I will remember your ancient wonders. I will reflect on all you have done and meditate on your actions.
Lonely. And I
is lonely. Lord, please save me. And I'm just lonely.
Thank you very much.
All right. Hey, before you go, Brent wanted me to mention the last couple chapels here. So on Thursday, Brent is going to close our time out in the Gospel of Matthew. And then Friday, we're going to reveal the next school year's campus theme and have a time to, it's always a fun reveal, and then have a time to honor seniors. So that's the rest of this week. Sam read a psalm. What psalm was that? 77. And at the end of it, it said to meditate on the wonders of God. And I hope today, just for a little bit, we were able to do that. I just want to encourage you, even as you go from this chapel and really the rest of your summer, look for God's wonders. He's always doing something amazing, and he's always at work. And look for his wonders. And let that fuel your joy and fuel your worship in him. Let me just pray as we close. God, we're so thankful for just being able to enjoy you and enjoy this music that you've given these students. And we just want to go in the strength that you provide. Help us to finish this year well. And we want to commit ourselves to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, I'm going to have the students that perform today, they're going to come in front of the stage. If you want to just encourage them or say a word to them, or maybe the way that their music encouraged you today, they're going to be out here and you can speak with them. All right, you're dismissed.